Let's see what all this looks like in Swift. To begin, you'll want to download the starter project for the Image Request app. A download link's posted in the instructor notes. I've downloaded the project already, so let's run it and see what we have. The interface is extremely simple. There's just a single label in the center, and it says that an image will load over this label. If we stop the app and go to the main storyboard, we can see there's actually an image view too, but it currently doesn't have an image. It'll be our job to get an image from the internet and display it within this image view. Now let's open the viewcontroller.swift file. We're going to be doing all our networking code right within its viewDidLoad method. The first class I want to introduce you to is NSURL. As you might have guessed, this class lets us represent a URL. I'll create an instance of it called ImageURL and initialize it using a URL string that I copied beforehand. This is a URL for a cat image that I like. Feel free to use your own URL, but make sure that it's HTTPS. We haven't talked about HTTPS yet, but we'll see why it's important later in this lesson. Now that we have a URL, the next step is making a request. The class that we'll use for this is called NSURLSession. NSURLSession is a class that can manage network requests on our behalf. We can create our own NSURLSessions with custom settings, or we can use the shared NSURLSession, which comes preloaded with default settings. The shared NSURLSession is what is known as a singleton. If you've never heard of a singleton before, it's a special kind of object that can only be instantiated once. So if I use the shared NSURLSession in this Swift file, and then in another file I use the shared NSURLSession, I'm actually still referring to the same object in both files because it's a singleton and there can only ever be one. The use of singletons is common when it makes sense to only have one instance of an object. Now, this distinction may not be incredibly important to you now, but I wanted you to know what the term meant in case you see it again. Anyways, we don't need to make custom NSURL sessions, so we'll just use the shared NSURL session for now. If you are interested in creating your own custom NSURL sessions, then you can look at the NSURL session configuration class. It allows you to change things like the amount of time you're willing to wait for a network request before canceling it.